So good morning, standard 10 students. Now in the previous class, I had told you how Bassanio had confessed to Portia that when he first met her, he had imparted some of his personal life to her, especially regarding his financial position. But now he said, when I did first impart my love to you, I freely told you all the wealth I had ran in my veins, it was in my blood. I was a gentleman, and then I told you true. Yet, dear lady, rating myself at nothing, you shall see how much I was a braggart when I told you my state was nothing. I shouldn't have told you that I was worse than nothing. Okay. So he says, now, like we all know, this money had been borrowed from Shylock, and then Bassanio had come and furnished himself to take part or to compete with the other rich suitors. So at that time he was showing off, okay, that he was, you know, a gentleman and a rich guy, and he was boasting a lot about his wealth. But actually he is confessing. He's saying, actually I should have told you the truth earlier, that my financial state is not very good. I am like a Mr. Nobody. It is as good as nothing. Since I don't have sufficient wealth. So if I had come here, it is because of my dear friend. He was the one who I have engaged. He says, I have engaged my best friend, who is now engaged to his worst enemy. He says, for my sake, my best friend had to borrow and risk his life in the hands of his bitter enemy. So now he is telling her the truth, that he is not a very rich person. At the beginning he was showing off. He was a gentleman and he was bragging or boasting. He was showing off. But now he says, I should have then told you the real truth. Okay. To feed my means to satisfy or to. Here is a letter, lady. That paper has the body of my friend, and every word in it a gaping wound, issuing lifeblood. Now he compares that letter to, like, the letter, the paper is like the body of Jesus Christ. And the wordings in that letter is compared to the wounds that was given to Jesus Christ when he was being crucified on the cross. You will find he has got a crown made out of thorns, and there is blood trickling down his face and head. Then he was nailed to the cross. You will find blood there also. Then you will find a spear mark in his chest here and there. Then on the feet. So because the Christians believe that Jesus Christ suffered for us or to save mankind. So he has compared that sadness to the letter which Antonio has sent him. The paper is the body, and the wordings is the blood of his dear friend. Okay. Then he turns to Salerio. saying, is it true that not one of his ships at all this venture failed? What, not one hit from Tripoli's, from Mexico and England, from Lisbon, Barbary and India, and not one vessel escaped the dreadful touch of merchant marring rocks? So he's got so many ships, one from Mexico, Tripoli, West Indies, Barbary and all that. He said, you mean to say not one of his ships escaped from those dangerous rocks? Now, merchant marring rocks means we're talking about those rocks that have ruined the merchants, means the owner of ships. That is why it is called a merchant marring rocks, where many of the merchants were ruined due to those dangerous rocks present in the sea. And not one vessel escaped. So then Salerio says, not one, my lord. Besides, it should appear that he had the present money to discharge the Jew. He would not take it. Never did I know a creature that did bear the shape of man, so keen and greedy to confound a man. Okay. Now here he says, not one, my lord, not one of his ship had escaped, all are gone. And then he says, now the situation of Antonio is that actually he is not able to pay the money. Okay. But even if he wants to pay the money, so I find it very funny that Shylock, such a greedy man, who is now not demanding for the money, all right, he is now demanding for the pound of flesh. So in order to get that pound of flesh, he is now pressurizing the Duke day and night that he wants justice. So he is challenging the court of law in Venice that he wants the pound of flesh. Whereas the Duke, the Magnificos, the other merchants, 20 more merchants, all were trying to convince Shylock. They were reasoning out with him that do not take the pound of flesh. You can take more money or double the amount or take some of his property or take one of his ships. But he says, this man, Shylock, he has the revengeful attitude in him. He does not want the money. Now, being a greedy man, he said, that is what he found it very strange. So a greedy man does not want money, but he wants that pound of flesh. Now, actually what happens, nobody knows the underlying motive of Shylock, why he wants that pound of flesh. They feel it is a penalty. Since Antonio is not able to pay the money on time, so he is exacting a pound of flesh, which is inhuman. So they're trying to reason that out, that okay, you can charge him double or 10 times more, or take away some of his property if he's not able to pay back the money on time. Now, for a greedy man, he is not accepting money. So that is what Salerio finds it very strange. Okay. Now, Jessica, she intervenes, she comes into the conversation, and now she is explaining. So she is telling Bassanio, when I was living with my father, when I was in my father's house, I had heard by Father Shylock. He was talking to Tubal and Cus. These two are Jews and moneylenders. The name of Tubal we have already heard him earlier, a good friend who had gone in search of Jessica. Then he will also mention in Act 1, Scene 3, when Shylock says, "I do not know whether I have that amount of money, but my friend Tubal will furnish me with the rest." So now, he says, when he was talking to them, I heard him very clearly say that if Antonio does not pay back the money on time, then I will exact that pound of flesh. Even if they pay me 20 times more than what I give, I am not going to accept it. I will demand for that pound of flesh. He says, now if Antonio is unable to pay the money on time to my father, then it will go hard on him. Means the case is going to be very serious against Antonio. So this information you have to keep. How Jessica had made the readers to be convinced that Shylock is not going to accept any amount of money, but he is obstinate, or he is demanding for that pound of flesh, and now he is challenging the law of Venus, that he needs his justification. Then Portia says, "Is it your dear friend that is thus in trouble?" Then Portia tries to ask whether it is the same friend, that is Antonio, who is in trouble. Now Bassanio is now, you know, very emotionally affected or sad. So he says, "The dearest friend to me, a very close friend of mine, and the kindest man, the best conditioned and unwearied spirit in doing courtesies, and to whom the ancient Roman honor more appears than any that draws bread in Italy." So he says, Antonio is a very good friend, close friend to me. He is also a very kind-hearted person, always ever ready to help people whenever they are in need. In Venice, he is given the respect of a Roman emperor. When the people of Rome, when they honor their emperor, they build statues in every creek and corner, since they cannot meet the emperor personally. So they show their respect by honoring or respecting them in the marketplace. He says, there is nobody in Venice who is so highly respected in Venice like how highly and respected and honored the Roman emperor is there in Italy. So I shall end till here, and I shall continue in the next recording. Thank you.